Hello, I'm Dr. Mark Hans, Chairman of the Department of Orthodontics at Case Western Reserve University School of Dental Medicine. The dental school is proud to be creating smiles across the miles at our new orthodontic clinic in downtown Shanghai. Through a partnership with Zhongtong University, our American clinic offers quality orthodontic care to Chinese families and the international business community. This unique partnership is the first of its kind in China, filling a critical niche in the developing global community.
Hi, I'm Jackie Lipton, Professor of Law and the Associate Director of the Frederick K. Cox International Law Center here at the Case Western Reserve University School of Law. Our international law programs are recognized as amongst the very best. In August of 2005, we established the Case Abroad at Home program. Each year, legal experts from around the world come to teach innovative mini-courses. This semester, we hosted distinguished faculty from Ireland, Australia, Nova Scotia, and Italy, and they shared their worldly insights with our students. Case Abroad at Home enriches our curriculum and helps make Case Western Reserve University a preeminent place to engage in global legal studies.
Greetings from the School of Engineering. I'm Stuart Rowan.
And I'm Chris Vader. Stuart and I are part of an interdisciplinary research team that has developed a new family of mechanically adaptive polymers.
These new polymers can change from a hard to a soft plastic, and vice versa, in a matter of seconds when exposed to a chemical stimulus. The inspiration for the design of these new materials came from a rather strange place, the sea cucumber.
These creatures can quickly change the stiffness of their skin to adapt to their surroundings. By mimicking nature's design, we created materials that exhibit a similar behavior. Their adaptable properties seem to be useful for many applications.
Together with our colleagues Dustin Tyler and Jeff Capodona, we're currently exploring their use as brain implants. We think that the adaptive nature of these materials will help to avoid rejection by the body.
Hi, I'm Letitia James, and I'm the director for the Center for Community Partnerships at Case Western Reserve University. Many people are unaware of the positive impact that Case Western Reserve University plays in the community every day. As a campus, we coordinate over 500 programs with nearly 600 community partners, and we invest nearly 400,000 hours of volunteer service each year. Our programs not only impact 9 local school districts, but 29 international countries as well. From our National Youth Sports Program to Case for Community Day, together we're making a positive difference in the community.
I'm Chris Palczewski, Chair of the Department of Pharmacology at the School of Medicine. We know that certain types of blindness are inherited. One cause of the disease known as Leber congenital amaurosis is due to the loss of an enzyme required for the eye to detect light. Our work with animal models with this disease suggests that there are two possible ways of treating this condition. The first video demonstrates the pupillary light responses in the left eye as an effect of an oral treatment with niacin retinal acetate. The second video shows the increased sensitivity to light as a result of intraocular injection of the virus carrying the missing gene. Our research indicates that this treatment, both orally and through gene transfer, show great potential toward ending blindness in Leber congenital amaurosis patients.
I'm Lee Thompson from the College of Arts and Sciences. Over the last 8 months, faculty, staff, and students worked closely to develop a strategic plan for the college. Along the way, we rediscovered who we are as we decided who we want to be. The strength and breadth of the college lies in our scholarship, our research, and our creative endeavors. From our unique theater MFA program in collaboration with the Cleveland Playhouse, to our Baker Nord Center's exploration of culture, creativity, and design, from our study of the universe through our participation in the Mercury mission, and our research programs in cosmology and astrophysics, to our basic science and applied research on social inequality and human health in our own backyards and around the world. We are the core of the university, and we are energized and excited about the future.
I'm Fred Colopy, a professor of information systems in the Weatherhead School of Management. Under the umbrella Managing as Designing, we've been conducting research aimed at understanding how the knowledge of great designers could be used to enhance the training of great managers. Working with designers in areas such as architecture, industrial design, graphic design, theater, and the arts, we've identified attitudes, techniques, and perspectives that can readily be applied to improving how we manage organizations and society.
Hello, I'm Shirley Moore, Professor of Nursing and Director of the SMART Center at the Francis Payne Bolton School of Nursing. The SMART Center is one of only two NIH-funded centers in the country designed to develop and disseminate knowledge related to self-management of health. The SMART Center integrates several disciplines across the university, including nursing, medicine, economics, psychology, engineering, and social work. The SMART Center aims to reinvent traditional healthcare by building the science of self-management. What is self-management? It's helping people to take a proactive role in their healthcare, to become better informed about their conditions, and engaged in shared decision-making about actions to support healthier living. The SMART Center is a national leader in self-management research and dissemination, advancing the way for individuals and their healthcare providers to become true partners in care.
Hi, my name is Mark Joseph, and I'm an assistant professor at the Mandel School of Applied Social Sciences, which is our graduate school of social work here at Case Western Reserve. A pressing issue that we face as a society, and right here in our city of Cleveland, is how to decrease persistent poverty. Research has shown that one key factor is continued high levels of segregation by race and by class. My research focuses on the possibilities and the limitations of a strategy called mixed income housing, which is being implemented across the US, over in Western Europe, and also right here in the Tremont neighborhood of Cleveland. So far, we're learning that it is possible to attract people from a wide variety of socioeconomic backgrounds to live together in the same housing development. The question now remains, is it possible to build community within that housing complex?
You've seen some fantastic work of Case Western Reserve University faculty. Now it's time to highlight a very special staff member. I'm Suzette Williamson with the Institute for Management and Engineering. The MEM program is privileged to have Ms. Ramona David as our admissions and program manager. MEM is a growing success, and that's due in large part to Ramona's positive interaction with students and alumni. She's known for her responsiveness, not only to students, but instructors and the unplanned campus visitors that some might view as an interruption. Ramona is the quintessential optimist. Last year, she underwent a kidney transplant, prior to which she was required to begin many days at 4:30 a.m. to undergo dialysis before putting in a full day in our office. What's so amazing is that most had no idea of Ramona's illness until the day she received the long-awaited call telling her a match had been made. This year, Ramona was one of three staff members to receive the President's Award for Distinguished Service, and she continues to earn it day after day. Ramona, on behalf of the staff, students of the MEM program, thank you for being a friend, advisor, mentor, and mother away from home.